Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. And nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Today's episode focuses on the University of Kansas. As usual, we'll start out at the point guard position. With a lot of great point guards to choose from, I settled on 6'3" Kirk Heinrich, who led Kansas to the 2002 Final Four and followed that up with a trip to the championship game in 2003, stopped only by Carmelo Anthony's Syracuse squad. A two-time All-Big 12 selection, Heinrich established a Jayhawk record as a sophomore, shooting 50.5% from three-point range. He ranks fourth all-time in assists, with 668, averaging nearly 5 per game for his career, while his 236 three-pointers ranks third all-time. He was selected 7th overall in the 2003 NBA Draft, earning all-rookie first-team honors with the Chicago Bulls. Voted team captain 4 consecutive years, Heinrich is also the Bulls' all-time leader in three-point field goals made. Shooting guard. Because of his defensive prowess and clutch shooting, I'm going with 6'2" Mario Chalmers. A Big 12 all-defensive team selection in each of his 3 years in Lawrence, he earned the Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year in 2007. As a freshman, he set the Big 12 record for steals in a season by a freshman with 89. As a sophomore, he established the Jayhawks' single-season record for steals with 97, a feat he matched the following year. His 180 three-pointers made ranks 7th all-time, while his 41.9 three-point shooting percentage ranks 6th. His dramatic three-point shot at the end of regulation in the 2008 NCAA Tournament Championship game against the Memphis Tigers sent the game to overtime, enabling the Jayhawks to bring home their 5th national title. He was chosen in the second round of the 2008 NBA Draft, earning all-rookie second-team honors with the Miami Heat in 2009 and helping the team win the 2012 NBA Championship as a starter. Small forward. I'm going to have to go with 6'7" Paul Pierce. Named the Big 8 Freshman of the Year in 1995, he was a two-time first-team All-Big 12 selection and a first-team All-American in his junior season when he scored 777 points, the 5th highest single-season total in Kansas history. A great all-around player, his 1,768 points ranks 8th all-time, while his 370 career free throws made is good for 7th. He was selected 10th overall in the 1998 NBA Draft by the Boston Celtics, where he has played his entire career. A 10-time All-Star, he brought home the 2008 NBA title as the NBA Finals' most valuable player. He is one of only 3 Celtics to score more than 20,000 points and is the organization's career leader in 3-point field goals made. Power forward. This spot goes to possibly the greatest Jayhawk of all time, 6'10", Danny Manning. He was a 3-time Big 8 Player of the Year and a 2-time All-American. His 2,951 career points is tops in school history by more than 800. He is also the career leader in rebounds, 2nd in free throws made, 7th in block shots, all while compiling an astounding 59.3 field goal percentage. He led an undermanned Jayhawk squad to the 1988 NCAA title, sweeping all postseason awards, including the Naismith and the Wooden. He was the first overall selection in the 1988 NBA Draft and was a 2-time All-Star and recipient of the 1998 Sixth Man of the Year Award, retiring with more than 12,000 points in his career. Center. This spot goes to the imposing 7'1" Wilt Chamberlain. During his freshman season at Kansas, he famously dominated a varsity squad favored to win their conference title, scoring 42 points, grabbing 29 rebounds, and blocking 4 shots. During his 2 varsity seasons with Kansas, he averaged a school-best 29.9 points and 18.3 rebounds per game, earning consensus All-American honors both seasons. He was named the most outstanding player of the 56-57 NCAA tournament, despite losing in the finals to North Carolina. He went on to a record-setting NBA career, becoming the only player ever to score 100 points in an NBA game, and averaging an amazing 30.1 points and 22.9 rebounds per game over the course of his career. Now for our second team, starting at point guard. With all due respect to Darnell Valentine, this choice comes down to three players that all set assist records at Kansas: Cedric Hunter, Aaron Miles, and my choice, Jacques Vaughn. A 6'1", two-time All-American selection, Vaughn was the 1996 Big 8 Player of the Year. By the end of his college career, he was the all-time leader in assists in Jayhawks history, as well as the Big 8 Conference record holder. The ultimate distributor, his 7.68 assists per game in 1995 is the highest single-season total in Jayhawk history. He also compiled over 1,200 points and 100 three-pointers in his college career. He was chosen 27th overall in the 1997 NBA draft. He spent 12 years in the NBA, serving primarily as a backup and winning an NBA title with San Antonio in 2007. Shooting guard. An impossible choice to make here, with great shooters like Terry Brown, Jerrod Haas, Jeff Boshy, Adonis Jordan, and Sharon Collins all realistic choices. But I'm going off the reservation with 6'4", Rex Walters. A two-year player after his transfer from Northwestern, Walters was the Big 8 Newcomer of the Year in 1992 and an All-Big 8 selection during both his seasons in Lawrence, leading the Jayhawks to the 1993 Final Four. He shot 41.8% from three-point range in his two seasons, seventh highest all-time, draining 151 three-pointers and averaging more than 15 points per game, while establishing the school's career record for free throw percentage at 84.9. He was the 16th overall pick in the 1993 NBA draft and went on to play parts of nine seasons in the league. Small forward. With a passing nod to Brandon Rush, I'm giving this spot to 6'5", Milt Newton, whose career 44.6 three-point shooting percentage is the best in Jayhawks history. An all-tournament team selection on 1988's national championship team, Newton was 6-for-6 from the field in the championship game, including 2 three-pointers to help the Jayhawks win the title. He was team captain and a second-team All-Big 8 selection the following year as a senior when he averaged 17.7 points and 5 rebounds per game. Undrafted by the NBA, Newton played professionally in Belgium, Australia, and in the CBA before entering the business side of basketball, currently serving as the Washington Wizards Vice President of Player Personnel. Power forward. Thomas Robinson is tough not to choose here. So are Drew Gooden, Clyde Lovellette, and Wayne Simeon. But I'm going with 6'10", Nick Collison. He was an All-Big 12 selection as a sophomore before leading the Jayhawks to back-to-back Final Fours in 2002 and 2003, winning both Big 12 and National Player of the Year honors as a senior. He's the second all-time leading scorer in Jayhawk history behind only Danny Manning and finished his career as the all-time leading scorer in Big 12 history. He also ranks third on the school's career rebounding list and was the 12th overall pick in the NBA draft by the Seattle Supersonics, averaging 7.1 points and 6.1 rebounds per game as a key reserve over the past 8 seasons. Center. After giving consideration to Cole Aldrich, Greg Ostertag, Mark Randall, Scott Pollard, Eric Chenoweth, and even current shot-blocking specialist Jeff Withey, this spot belongs to 6'11", Rafe LaFrance. A 4-year starter and 2-time All-American and Big 12 Player of the Year, LaFrance grabbed the second most rebounds in Jayhawk history while becoming only the third player to surpass the 2,000-point barrier. He accumulated a record of 123-17. Winning more games over a 4-year stretch than any other player, with an impressive 87.9 winning percentage. As a senior, he became the first Jayhawk in 27 years to average a double-double over an entire season. He was the third overall pick in the NBA draft, averaging over 10 points and 6 rebounds per game during his 10-year career. So there you have it, the all-time best lineup for the Kansas Jayhawks. Thanks for watching again on All-Time Best College Basketball Edition. We'll see you next time.